Well, the highlight of many kids' summer is being dropped off at camp. But a lot of parents are struggling with whether it's safe to send their kids this year. Reporter Lindsay Boach set out to find out what summer camp experts recommend and how camp will look different.
That's a familiar sound for many American kids. Whether it's just a day camp or an overnight camp, thousands of children get amped up to spend the summer hanging out with old friends, meeting new ones, and doing different activities. But now,
a lot of camps right now are trying to make decisions about summer, and they've been trying to do that for quite a while.
That's American Camp Association President Tom Rosenberg. The group accredits camps all over the country. He and his team have worked with health experts and the YMCA of the USA to put together new regulations for hosting camp this summer in places where government officials have given the okay.
Kids are starved, frankly, just absolutely starved for emotional and social connection. They spend hours online, like almost like cast adrift in a sea of screens. Those kids that have screens, but they're feeling a deep sense of loneliness and isolation from their friends.
He says the preparation for kids going to camp will start early.
Before you even arrive at camp, parents are going to be requested to pre-screen campers for 7 to 10 days before camp begins to make sure that they are well.
Kids will be screened every day in the morning and monitored throughout the day. If a camper has symptoms, Rosenberg says the parents will be called and they will have to come get their child.
There'll be a focus on camper is using individual equipment that is assigned to them instead of sharing equipment. You'll see the types of activities being offered, focusing on those that can be done by small family household groups of campers.
Those small family households won't necessarily be siblings, just small groups of kids who will be together the duration of camp and will have the same camp counselors throughout as well.
So they'll move through camp as a group, making group decisions about activities.
But most importantly, Rosenberg says you'll still see camp in most places, which he says is going to be very beneficial for kids' well-being.
You're going to see camp. You're going to see a social surge in these kids who have been isolated for 12 weeks, having fun, connecting with the friends inside their family circle.
Just a few changes to help ensure the kids are safe. I'm Lindsay Boach reporting.